It's really never been easier to get an access to vaccines, particularly as we close in on 80% later this week. And currently, the most important thing we can do is to step forward and support our frontline healthcare workers, our community-controlled organisations like this, and get vaccinated. That continues to be the message, and it's a message that we need lots of different ways to get community engagement through. And that's to make sure that we avoid completely avoidable hospitalisations through COVID-19 by getting as many people with those double jabs in their arms. And currently there are actually 802 people in our Victorian healthcare system with COVID-19 in our hospitals. Some 152 of those are in intensive care and 92 are currently on a ventilator. Very sadly, 7 people lost their lives yesterday in the reporting period to COVID-19. A woman in her 20s, a man in his 40s, a man in his 60s, two women and a man in their 80s, and a man in his 90s. We particularly just take this opportunity to reflect and send our deepest condolences to all those families, communities, and friends of those people who have tragically passed away. There were also some 56,905 tests done yesterday. Jerome will talk a bit more about testing, but we want to make sure that, particularly as higher levels of vaccination start to play out in the community and we move around more, it's just as important as ever to come forward and get tested. And we want to make sure that those testing numbers stay as high as they possibly can. There were also, in terms of the total case numbers, 1,461 confirmed cases of coronavirus locally acquired yesterday, bringing to total 24,831 active cases of COVID-19 in our community. And it's important, therefore, that opportunities like this, where the Victorian Community Control health organisations, such as the Victorian Aboriginal Health Service, are out there leading the community engagement efforts in those communities that continue to be underrepresented in those vaccination statistics.